this kind of weather.
Mom, where's the celery? What could it be better?
Just come right on over and make yourself comfy.
Hey, Daddy, where are you going? To the mall?
She is your mother.
Make yourself comfy.
Tonight
we stay sober.
Cause nobody's in the
pouring
rain. And things they ain't perfect, but I wouldn't change a thing.
Once upon a time in Armut Village in West Kalimantan, Indonesia, there lived an old widow with a beautiful daughter named Darmi. They lived in a hut located at the edge of the village. Since Darmi's father died, their life has become difficult. Darmi's father did not leave any inheritance. To meet their daily needs, Darmi's mother works in other people's fields as wage labor. Meanwhile, Darmi is a spoiled girl. Whatever his must be granted. Not only spoiled, she is also a lazy girl. She only works on cleaning and admiring her beauty in front of the mirror. Every evening he was always going around in her village without any purpose, but just to show off her beauty. She did not want to help her mother earn money. Every time her mother asked her to go to the rice fields, she always refused.
Come on, help me working in the fields, please.
No, Mom, I didn't want to go to the rice fields. It will make me angry just like you.
Don't you feel sorry for saying you like this, don't you?
No, it's only you who works in the field. You are all ends of it.
Listening her Darmi's explore, the mother was speechless. With a sad feeling, she went to the rice field to work. Meanwhile, Darmi still lives in the hut, keeps on grooming to beauty herself. After her mother returned from the fields, Darmi asked for the celery her mother received to buy her makeup.
Mom! For the celery?
No, Darmi. This money is to buy our daily needs today.
But Mom! I run after my makeup, I have to buy a new one.
You are really bad girl. You just spend your time for spending money in grocery.
Although angry, the mother still gave the money to Darmi. The next day, when her mother come home from work, Darmi asks again for the salary her mother reached to buy another makeup. This situation occurs almost every day. One day, when her mother was going to the market, Darmi ordered her to buy makeup. But her mother did not know the makeup she made. Then her mother asked her to come to the market.
Then let's go with me to the market.
I don't want to go to the market with you.
But I don't know what the makeup you asked Darmi.
After the party, Darmi was also willing to go with her mother to the market.
One condition, you have to work behind me.
But why?
I am asking if all the people in this village know that you are my mom. Look at you! You are so old and you're angry. Why for you? Please meet them. I'm your mom.
Mom, look at your wrinkled face and your dirty clothes. I am asking to have such a messy mother.
The mother complied with her daughter's request. After that, they went to the market together. Darmi walks while her mother follows behind her with a basket. Even though they are both mother and daughter, their appearance look completely different, as if they weren't the same family. Darmi looks beautiful in beautiful clothes, while her mother looks very old in dirty and hollow clothes. On the way, Darmi meet her friends who live in another village.
Where are you going?
To the market.
Who is behind you? She is your mother.
Of course not, she is my...
First night, the daughter goes to her will share her daughter words, but she just keep calm and hold her thirst back.
Where are you going, Darmi?
To the market.
Who is behind you?
She is my housemate.
her dagger word make her mother shaken, but her mother kept holding it. That's what happened continuously during their way to the market. Finally, her mother can't hold it anymore, so she just stopped walking and sit on the roadside. Her dagger, and she keep praying to God to punish her deserving dagger.
Hey mom, what are you doing? Mom! Oh God! Forgive me! I'm too weak! I can hold it on me longer. Give her punishment she deserves.
A few minutes later, suddenly sky became darker, thunder stickled everywhere. But Darmy's body turned to be stone. Teddy Chan started from legs, body
mom,
to the top.
Mom, where are you going? On my legs. I'm sorry, Mom. I will be good girl. I promise, Mom.
Not long after that, the weather became normal again, just like it was to be. Darmy has completely become a stone. People put the stone on the wayside lane to the alley. They named it Batu Menangis.